Fall has arrived, and so have the latest trends at JCPenney. Starting Thursday, save 50% on your favorite styles of select apparel, accessories, and fine jewelry. Save on Exertion activewear, Arizona apparel for the family, and St. John's Bay apparel for him and her. No coupons needed for these savings. Plus, get up to 80% off final markdowns in-store and at jcp.com. Hurry, sale ends Sunday. That's getting your pennies worth. JCPenney. Prices valid 9/28 to 10/1 in-store only. Selections vary by store while supplies last. Fittings on regular and original prices. Intermediate markdowns may have been taken. Some exclusions apply. See store or jcp.com for details.
Hi, you guys. This is Good Bees, and I'm Dr. Renee Sunday. I know you don't have to say a word. I know you're having a marvelous, a fabulous, a super fantastic day. No matter where you are, if it's day, night, afternoon, you may be checking us out live, or you may actually be on our archive or on iTunes, YouTube, you somewhere. But the thing about it doesn't matter what's going on in your life right now, because the thing about it, we do. And I'm saying we, that's all of us. We do have to go through trials and tribulations. We have to go through things that we know are good and things that we think that is not so good. We say they bad. This is not a good situation. But let me let you know on the secret. We actually, you don't feel it when you're going through it, okay? But you do have to go through good and bad, and we actually learn from those things, okay? And we actually, it develops us. I know, yeah. I think Bishop Jake said it the best, that your pain becomes what? Your purpose. Because you know that sensitive thing that's going on with that, right? So when someone says that they have not had food, that they have lost their job, that they actually, they just don't, they mind just one day they were starting the next thing, or they could say like I did, I went from six figures to zero in one day. Yeah. Oh, yes. I can tell you about some money. I know how to repurpose myself, reinvent myself, to get back to the six and to the seven, okay? But anyway, the thing about it is what we deem that's not good, it always actually is good to help somebody else and help ourselves as well, okay? But we got a powerhouse going on. But let me tell you, the question of the day or the week that people say, ask Dr. Renee. And the question my team, they so funny. The question is, well, Dr. Sunday, all the things that you have, they said what I do, but, you know, I usually always say what I have been entrusted to do. We didn't realize you actually do a lot for volunteer. Yes, I do. And they wanted to know a little bit about that. But actually, I grew up that way. My mom and dad always went to the shelter. They always kept the needy, you know, in the church, outside the church, in the neighborhood. As a child, I was the young lady that gave my bicycle away. Yeah. Because the girl, you know, I just felt that, you know, her parents couldn't afford it. And I, you know, of course, I got chastised. I got a whipping when I got home. Okay. But, my mom, we think back on that, that I actually always have been a giver, a cheerful giver. And the thing is, we always continue that as you continue to develop. You always give things back to people. And I always like to bring people with me, okay, while I'm going. But, you know, we always help people. You never know. And people say, well, how you know? When I have peace about a thing, I'm always giving, okay? So that's just a general rule. But that's just a nutshell. I talked to the person a good while on the telephone because, you know, that's my thing. I can go in on that. But the thing about it is always be able to help somebody else because you never know what they're going through. And first of all, they think that they're all alone, number one. Right. And then the things that we go through, they actually help somebody else, but it actually mature you as well that you realize that you ain't all that. Yeah, we think that sometimes, but let me let you know that it's not about us, okay? Y'all know I can go there, so let me be good, okay? But I am your host. It's the new people. They set some new folks on. I am Dr. Renee Sunday, and I am the platform builder. Some people call me the be seen, be heard, get paid expert. So you better get ready. You're going to be seen, you're going to be heard, and guess what? You're going to get paid. We love that, right? But you want to have impact and you want to have influence to help people go closer and closer to their destiny. And what we do in all the platforms I have been entrusted is help you shine your light to the world. And what is that light? Your light is your dreams, your goals, your passion, the reason you were born. I just got to let you know that you wasn't a mistake, okay? I love it. I love it. I love it. But let's get busy here because I have some powerhouses in the house today. We actually going to have a great conversation about what, you know, of course, we love to talk about our purpose in life, the things that makes us tick, the things that gets us up at 3 in the morning and go to bed sometime at midnight, okay, or don't go to bed at all, but that driving force that actually helps us continue on what we call this journey called life, right? And then also how we are part of the community. What are we doing in the community? What are we really doing in the community? So I have two people that's powerful in their own right that actually, and I'm actually have been truly honored to be a part of this as well. So you'll be hearing more of this, that we're going to actually introduce them, and then we're going to let them tell us about themselves. And then, of course, the major initiative, the innovative thing that has been put on their heart, guess what, to help somebody else. And y'all think I'll be planning this, okay? My team had me the question right before I got on the air. So it always worked out. What it said, all things work together, right? So we want to welcome, first of all, the CEO and the founder of In God's Hand, nonprofit organization. This awesome young lady is Chanta Rose. Are you there?
Yes, I am. How are you?
Welcome to Good Deeds. Woo! Have mercy. I love it. I love it. I love it. And we also have a powerhouse. I'm the latest kind of be good now. We have an international, I love to say international, recording artist, Mr. Darryl Allen. Are you there?
Hey, hey now. How you doing?
Now, see, I like young people. He's going to mess around, and I'm going to go in and put my little skinny jeans on. Okay, let me stop. Okay. Y'all know I'm crazy. But, Lord, y'all know I'm funny. Lord, I don't believe I said that on the air. Okay, this is Renee. I am Renee when I just said that. But tell us a little bit more about yourself and the amazing things that's going on in your life.
Well, In God's Hands was established in 2004, and God gave me In God's Hands, letting me know that I would be doing a lot of work in the community. I was raised as always helping, and that's just something my mother instilled in me very young, and for which I also instill in my children. So I have given out toys for the holidays. I have given back to school supplies. I've given out coats. And really, a lot of these things have come out of my own pocket. 2009, I gave away over 6,500 toys to families. And it was just me and my four kids that did that. I'm sorry, three kids. It was four of us total. And we were able to give out these toys, I'm telling you, in less than 3 hours. And we had a mass of people. Every year before that and after that, I usually give out 3,000 to 4,000. But now we're having a school bus that we're converting into a food truck to stop childhood hunger. And we're holding a 5K race in the Stone Mountain Village area on October 21st. And we're collaborating with It Takes a Village Festival. Now, I would like everyone to come out. I would like some sponsors. And I would love for them to register at coolsteps.com. I'm asking everyone, come out and support. You will enjoy yourself because we have live entertainment, which will be Darryl Allen and a few others. We'll be having Tiffany Meeks, Shane, what is the young lady's? I can't think of her name at the moment. Please forgive me. But we're going to have Bouncy House. It's just going to be a lot of food. It's going to be a lot of fun and entertainment. And I would really like everyone to come out and enjoy and also to support this cause.
Wow, that's powerful. I do want to step back a little bit because one thing I love to do and we love to do on this, on every platform that I've been entrusted, kind of educate us, not really with numbers, but bring a little bit of awareness to us, because a lot of people may not, I'm going to say may not, because you can't really judge what somebody else is thinking in their head. Childhood hunger, especially here in the Atlanta metro area.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit of just, you know, I know it's a lot, you know, numbers out there that we can look at, but tell us a little bit about that, because we actually need to have that awareness, that education, to be able to relate to it, number one. And then two, with us wanting, you know, I'll just be real. People want to ask those questions. Is it really here in Atlanta? So help us a little bit with that.
Oh, yes, it is. I mean, with my years of helping in the community, I find that the need is greater and greater every year. We've even given out packages for Thanksgiving. And like I said, it keeps growing and growing, especially with the market crashing a couple of years ago with real estate. It's left a lot of people homeless. You have a lot of families living in hotels that, I mean, they're paying more living there than they would actually on a mortgage or renting an apartment. So it's almost like the working poor. You're working, but all your needs are still not met. And I have had so many people come, and they're looking for help. And like I said, you know, I refer them to places. I give out of my own pocket. And it hurts me to be able to see a child or a family who nutritional needs are not met. You know, that's a horrible thing. I mean, I can thank God that I never had a situation where I suffered or my family suffered with hunger, but when you see other families that are begging and crying and don't know, you know, how to take care of their family to feed them, it's a horrible feeling. And we have places that want to give to other countries, but we have people right here in Georgia that really is in need.
Yeah, I can really attest to that. With our nonprofit organizations called Sunday Foundation, I found out firsthand how high the numbers are here in Atlanta. People working 9 to 5, and they don't even have food for food for them to eat.
Yeah.
They will actually have enough for their kids to kind of get by with one meal. In some cases, it wasn't even that. Trying to research this,
yeah,
ladies and gentlemen. I mean, Georgia in general, and I wasn't aware of this. I'm from Alabama. I just, you know, be honest. I didn't become aware of this, the numbers, until I actually got in the nonprofit segment myself. And I found out it's different categories of considered to being homeless. When we see people on the street, that's one type of homeless. I just want to educate you with this quickly. And then it's another type if they're not staying with their immediate family or if one of their family members are actually incarcerated or not. So actually, Georgia has different criteria. I don't know if that, I'm assuming that may apply with every state, but I didn't realize that until I got in that sector. But so I want to go back to the amazing event that's coming up. Let me ask you this. I love how you and your team crafted everything that's going to go on at the event. Tell us a little bit. You mentioned it briefly, but I love that you're going to have the fun. You're going to have the health, and then you're going to have the amazing artists sharing their purpose in life. But tell us a little bit of that's amazing how you put that together in regards of having those different facets involved in one event.
Say that again, Ms. Sunday. You wanted me to explain what now?
Well, we just wanted to know, with so many different things that you have involved in the event, We want to say it's a great thing that you actually have. I guess the point that I'm getting at, a lot of times we go to events that have the race, have the health component. But I love, love that you actually going to have the component also where we can celebrate and we can actually have fun. Because the thing about it is we know it's a need. We're going to bring the money. We're going to come out. We're going to make sure we do our health component. But we also need to make sure that we actually also celebrate life, that we actually going to stand in that gap to take care of our children.
Yes, yes, because, you know, when God tells us that, you know, it does. It takes a village to raise children. You understand? Are we our brother's keepers? We are. We are. We have to be able to care for what is going on with someone else, because eventually it will affect us as a whole. So I find that when you find people with like minds that are willing to come together for this cause and to help everyone, it is a celebration. It is a blessing to be on one accord. So, you know, we have this live concert and all these fun activities after the actual race, so people can feel love, can feel welcome, can feel celebrated, because sometimes your burdens are so heavy on your shoulders, you just want to be able to release. You want to not think about everything that's going on. And if NGOTS can help that, we welcome it.
Wow, I love it. I love it. I love it. And the thing that's so amazing, ladies and gentlemen, we have none other than the international recording artist, Darryl Allen, with us. And we want to bring him into this conversation because the last thing, and y'all think I'd be playing this, it all works out. The last thing you said, Ms. Rose, was it takes a village. So we're so proud to actually, you know, just people that's in the spotlight. I mean, Darryl Allen. I mean, come on now. Are you there, Darryl?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm listening.
So thank you so much for joining us also here on Good Deeds. Can you tell us just a little bit more about yourself? We've heard about you. We know the MO about you. But tell us a little bit more about, I mean, what drives you and how you just knew without a shadow of doubt that you need to be a part of this amazing event, this amazing initiative to prevent, okay, and eliminate child hunger.
Well, first and foremost, anybody that, you know, I'm associated with or that knows anything about me know, you know, I'm a giver. I'm happy off of seeing other people happy. You know, there's only so much we can do, but if we do it as a unit, it's bigger and it's better. So, I mean, I always try to surround myself around positive and do positive things at the same token. When it was brought to my attention that we were going to be doing this, I applauded the whole situation. So I was game from the door.
I love it. I have to always ask this question. I don't know. Y'all may not know. I'm a budding singer as well. But, you know, that's been ignited in my spirit. But I want to ask you this. I always ask this because I be getting tips myself. When you actually, before you perform, you know, we hear like Yolanda Adams, and I think I've heard even when it comes to football players, you know, I'm part of the media team for the NFL, and when the Falcons, you know, when they in their locker room, everybody has a little routine that they do. And, you know, I'm looking because I always like to see what they little routine. So do you actually, Darryl Allen, do you have a routine that you do, you know, the day that you're actually performing, that no matter what, like the football players, no matter what, they're going to have their shoes tied a certain way. Do you have an actual tradition like that that you do as well?
It's probably just with me the whole way to the event. I'm probably listening to music majority of the time. And then, you know, when I get there, yeah, me and my team or whatever, yeah, it's a prayer that goes on, you know, and it's a lot of stuff going on right now that needs prayer and help at the same token. So anything mm-hmm. that we can do as a unit, as a whole, as people, man, it all helps. It all counts. So, but, you know, I say my prayer or whatever, and I hit the stage, and we go from there and have fun.
Amen.
I love it. I love it. I mean, because people ask me that as well, ladies and gentlemen, that you know, the different hats that I have. Because sometimes on a given day, I go from anesthesia to nonprofit to radio, and then that night we in the studio or whatever. But that meditation in the beginning of the day, and then throughout the day, the prayer, that's it. Okay, so it's like I'm preaching. I am a minister, but it looks like I'm preaching in everything I'm doing. I am, because, you know, I'm in my purpose. Oh, Lord, y'all got me all excited. Y'all gonna make me hit a note, but I won't do it today. But I want to ask this. Darryl, the amazing, and I want you to, if it's okay, introduce your, ladies and gentlemen, we don't get a sneak peek, okay? You know, just over here on Good Deeds, they have entrusted us. Okay, on the lock and key. You cannot get this. No, I'm just kidding. Tell us a little bit about the amazing new hit you have coming up. And we're going to actually be able to listen to it. But, you know, it's always a somewhat of information that we love to hear from the artists themselves when it comes to their amazing singles and the amazing music that they put out to the public.
Well, it's a song that I wrote with me and a couple of my guys or whatever, but it's called Baby Love Crazy. And it's just that. Some days she's a baby, some days she's crazy, some days I'm crazy, some days I'm a baby. But it's all love, and we just kind of made it fun a little bit. And it's just, you just go through cycles in relationships of all kinds and whatnot. So, it's kind of self-explanatory, in a sense.
I love it. And ladies and gentlemen, just sit back and relax, and please, please enjoy this amazing hit. I'm already ready to I've heard it, so I know. You're going to enjoy this, and we're going to take a little break, and you're going to enjoy this. Now, listen to the words now, because you got to know what's going on. And we'll be right back. Now listen, listen, listen. You know this is Good Deeds, and I'm Dr. Renee Sunday.
Can't wait for your love. Anticipating your love, I'm tipsy, you thinking I'm crazy, baby. Got me drowning in love, I be craving your touch. Do you think about love? There's no better love, expecting your love, baby. You give me a buzz cut.
Your love drives me crazy.
It, baby, is this what you wanted, baby? Go deep in the middle line. So come and jump on it, baby. Like riding a roller coaster, keep you spinning over and over. Love that hump in your back, baby. Won't you come in like that, baby? Always driving me out. I swear you're driving me out of my mind. My mind. My mind, the way your love is driving me out.
Your love drives me crazy, but I don't mind being this crazy. So give me a straight jacket, you know that I gotta have it. Go ahead and drive me crazy.
Crazy loves baby, baby loves crazy. Yeah, we in love, baby. We in love. Baby loves crazy. Crazy loves baby. Yeah, we in love.
on that. Yeah, I know how to dance. Amen. Yeah, okay, you can say what you want to say. Amen. I am Dr. Renee Sunday, and we're back. You know, oh, I just love it, love it. I'm going to have to talk to them, see can I spin that a little bit more, okay? Throughout our show, you know, for the more and more. Wow, Darryl, that's amazing.
I'm glad you like it. It's kind of fun. It's a fun little song. We're going to do the video. It's going to be a fun video.
Oh, well, good. Now, you know, y'all know I act too now, so don't be forgetting the sister. No, I'm just kidding. That's a famous plug, right?
Yeah, maybe you can play the nurse.
Oh, I am an anesthesiologist for real, so I am in the medical field.
Yeah, I might need a little of that.
Darryl, how we can support you in the things that you're doing, and how we can support you as well on social media. I know we're gonna be at the event, but we want them to go and follow you and go and support you before the event.
Yeah, well, the IG is hashtag I am Darryl Allen, and that's DarryllAllen. I am Darryl Allen, all one word. And that's how you can get with me. When you look at it, look at that site. It's going to be at songsourcemusic.com. If you look at that, then you can get some of the information off of there and get a hold to me as well.
Wow. Well, thank you, thank you, thank you so much.
Thank you, thank you.
You're welcome. Shantae, I keep calling you Shantae. She told me Chanta, and I keep saying Shantae. Lord have mercy. Miss Rose,
okay.
Are you there?
It's all right. Yes, I am.
Well, you know, one thing about media personalities, we don't like messing people's days up. It's amazing, but that's one of our things. But tell us, let's recap before we leave. Let's recap a little bit and tell us. You did it so wonderfully when we started, but tell us again about the event, and then tell us, you know, how we can plug in if you need more. You did say sponsors, but do you need any more people to actually do the run or the walking or the running? And just tell us what you need to make it. I mean, we got to take care of this. I mean, come on, you guys.
Yes.
Come on, support us now.
Yes, well, you can register at coolsteps.com or coolstepseventbrite.com. I'm needing those to register, and I'm needing you to register now. We're also looking for sponsors, and you will be able to find a menu that, in other words, you will be able to be a sponsor or a vendor. But it's on October 21st. At the Stone Mountain Village area, we'll be starting at West Mountain Street at 9:30 a.m. We'll be having a Zumba exercise or class before the actual race. And then after the race, we have all these cool events, the live artists. We're going to have an area for the kids, Jumpy House, food, vending, and we just want everyone to come out and celebrate. And we're going to have an antique show also, antique car show. So it'll be a whole lot going on, and we're just really wanting people to come out and support Stop Childhood Hunger.
Wow, I love it, I love it. Now, ladies and gentlemen, do your thing now. Yes. I grew up in poverty, so... So as the Bible said, what good things come out of Nazareth, here I am to tell you. Hallelujah. Okay, I can go there now. But thank you. In God's hand. I just thank you for that. I thank you
for
international recording artist Darryl Allen and all of the people that's part of the event. You know, I always like to give props where it's due, from the planners, the people that's on your team, the people that's getting the place ready, the people that are going to bring the bouncers out. We just pray for everybody, Lord, that they will actually They know the cause that we need to take care of. And we thank you so much, and more to you, Miss Rose, and the things that have been instilled in your belly, as we say in the pulpit, that you actually, the things will come to pass, and we believe that, and it is so.
Yes, Lord, to God be the glory.
Wow. Now, thank you guys so much for being in your purpose. We thank you so much for being in your purpose and taking the time and being here with us on Good Deeds. If you need us for anything, please, please don't hesitate to contact us.
Okay. Thank you.
Linda, I appreciate you, too. Thanks a lot.
Yes. Yes.
You're welcome. You're
so
welcome.
Much love towards you. Thank you.
Woo, Lord. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, I can just cut the rug a minute. But anyway, but I thank you. You know me. If you need any information about advertising with us in regards of the radio show, the TV show, we actually, you know, we launching the Good Deeds magazine. Hey, hey. But, you know, the thing about it is you need to remember is good deeds, good things do happen every second. Guess what? Every day. If you want information about that, please contact us. Also, the publishing company. I know you got a book inside of you, so you need to get it out, okay? We can help you with that. If you need help writing it, you need help publishing it, and, of course, marketing it. All that go together, right? And then with the nonprofit organization is, you know, amen. You know what, go to the site and the things that you need. You may need something to eat. You may need a scholarship. You may have a loved one in the hospital. Hey, we'll find a way, okay? The thing about it is our website is www.reneesunday.com. That's R-E-N-E-E, Sunday, S-U-N-D-A-Y. But always remember, you do have a calling. You do have a reason you are born. You're not a mistake. You got to do the three things I always say. You got to believe, you got to trust, and you got to walk it out. You know the part I got to say right now is you got to don't stop. You got to get it. That means get your purpose and get your purpose now. One thing my team told me I forgot to say, amen. If you're a young lady, if you're a lady, a woman, we actually starting our women's fellowship back up, and we actually have that in a private location in Atlanta. We actually have sold out. I'm happy. I'm happy. I like the word sold out, but it's a free event. But get in contact with us. We're going to have them every month, and the key is to empower people, empower, inspire them that they can walk out their destiny. Okay? Now, I love you. I love you, love you. If I can help you with anything, please, please let us know. You know, this is Good Deeds, and I'm Dr. Renee Sunday. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Fall has arrived, and so have the latest trends at JCPenney. Starting Thursday, save 50% on your favorite styles of select apparel, accessories, and fine jewelry. Save on Exertion activewear, Arizona apparel for the family, and St. John's Bay apparel for him and her. No coupons needed for these savings. Plus, get up to 80% off final markdowns in-store and at jcp.com. Hurry, sale ends Sunday. That's getting your pennies worth. JCPenney. Prices valid 9/28 to 10/1 in-store only. Selections vary by store while supplies last. Savings on regular and original prices. Intermediate markdowns may have been taken. Some exclusions apply. See store or jcp.com for details.